Hello students, welcome to the channel Edifying Kids. Today we are going to learn English, class 7th, unit 2, 2.1 from a railway carriage by Robert Louis Stevenson. Students, if you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe it now and do share with your friends so that you will get regular notifications. Okay, now in this poem, the poet tells us that what he can see from a railway carriage. Poet describes his thrilling experience of a train journey. He presents the natural scene, the scene from the window of a railway carriage. Okay, now let's see the actual poem. Now see the first stanza. 2.1 from a railway carriage. Faster than ferries, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like troops in a battle, all through the meadows, the horses and cattle. Now see students, in this first stanza, different new words, you can see the new different words are coming here. Faster first, faster than fairies. Fairies means what? Fairies is a magical creature who does magic, usually a female character. Okay, then faster than witches. Witches means what? Witches is also a female character, woman who is believed to have a magical powers and who uses them to harm the people. Okay, bridges and houses, then hedges and ditches. Hedges means what? Next word is hedges. Hedges means a line of a bushes, small trees, small bushes planted very close to each other. And ditches means what? Ditches means a long, narrow, open channel dug into the ground, usually at the side of the road, both the side of a road or a field also. Okay, it is called ditches. And charging along like troops means a group of soldiers. Okay, troops in a battle, all through the meadows. Again one word, meadows means a field with a grass and often wild flowers in it. Okay, filled with a grass, the horses and cattle. Okay, now in this first stanza, see the first stanza, the poet describes many scene from the window of a railway carriage, and he says that the train runs faster than magical creatures such as fairies and witches. Okay, also poet sees bridges and houses also, ditches and hedges also, the horses and cattle in the meadows seem to rush away as if they were soldiers on a battlefield. Okay, this is the first stanza. Now see the second stanza. All of the sides of the hill and the plain fly as a thick as driving rain, and ever again in the wink of an eye painted stations whistle by. Now in the second stanza, your poet says that the train passes hills and the plains. Train passes hills and plains. The sights there fly away as thick as heavy rain. Now and again painted station pass by even before one can wink, before the wink of an eye. As the train passes these stations, the whistle of the engine is heard. Okay, whistle, we can hear the whistle when train passes these stations, painted stations. Okay, now next stanza. Here is a child who clambers and scrambles all by himself and gathering brambles. Here is a tramp who stands and gazes, and there is a green for stinging the daisies. Now see in the next stanza, here you can see the some words you can see over here. Here is a child. Now suddenly one sees a child who clambers and scrambles. Here clambers means what? To climb up across or into the somewhere with a very difficulty, using the hands and feet also. Means it is very difficult to climb. Clambers. Now next, what is the scrambled? Scrambled means to move or to climb quickly, but with a difficulty only. Okay, often using hands to for helping. Okay, all by himself and gathering brambles. Brambles means a wild bush with a thorn that produces the blackberries. Okay, thorny bush. Here is a tramp. Tramp means what? A person with a no home, jobless person or no money, person is not having money, who travels around and ask for money from other people. Means we can say wanderer. Okay, wanderer. Now, who's that man? Means he is a tramp, that person who is having job, without job, jobless person, who stands and gazes. Now, in this third stanza, here suddenly one sees a child all by himself. And what child is doing? Climbing with a very difficulty and gathering the bushes with the blackberries. Then one might see a jobless person standing and gazing. This will be followed by green grass with the children used to string daisies. Now here daisies means what? Daisies is the flower, daisy flower. Okay, with a white petals and a yellow center, which often grow in a grass. Okay, daisies. Now see the next stanza. Last stanza we'll see. Here is a cart run away in the road, lumping along with man and load. And here is a mill and there is a river, each a gleam and gone forever. Now here poet is saying that in the third stanza, again some words we can see, meaning of these words we'll see. Lumping along means moving with a jerk. Okay. Now glimpse. Glimpse means what? Something that you see for a very short time. Okay, very short time. Now here in the last stanza, now one sees a cart running away in the road, moving in a which type of movement is there? Lumping. Lumping means moving in a jerk as it carries man and load. Then one spot a mill followed by a river. Each sight is seen for a very short time. Glimpse. Each a glimpse and then gone forever means each sight is seen. We can see that scene for a very short time and then it is gone forever. Okay. So children, this is about the poem From a Railway Carriage. Hope students you understood this poem.